Hey everyone, Hans here. So today, another quick video on look-alike audiences. The other day, I recorded a video on how you can use Clay to build a look-alike audience. And today, we're going to explore a different method that you can use that includes Google search operators, in this case, the all-in-text operator. So Google search operators, I feel, are really underutilized tools when it comes to building lists or finding the right fit companies. And today I show you a little bit about why that is and how you can use them for yourself. So let's dive in. So here's the post I wrote about Google search operators on LinkedIn for anyone who hasn't read it. So using the all-in-text operator, we didn't use this exact search term, but then I went back and found that, you know, this is better than the one we used back in the day. So we were targeting lead generation agencies, and they didn't always have a really big online presence, or they weren't, let's say, categorized correctly in Sales Navigator or in databases. So as you may or may not know, like when you search for, you know, lead generation, that type of thing, you get all types of businesses in there, and it's tricky to find the right company. But as you get more familiar with your target market, your ICP, then you'll know that there are a lot of phrases that they'll be using on their website that you can really use to pick them out, to identify them, and to be able to see, okay, these guys are a good fit and these aren't. So in our case, and I'll go into a few more examples in a second, but in our case, there would, for example, be only pay per lead. That is just one really simple example, and they would need to be B2B companies, work with B2B companies. So, you know, what the all-in-text does, so let's break this down. So all-in-text, it needs to have phrase match only pay-per-lead. So it needs to have that exact phrase in there. And it needs to have the, you know, let's say word, or it needs to have the term B2B in there. And here I'm just negativing, that's not a word. I'm just telling it to ignore certain sites like Fiverr, YouTube, LinkedIn, because people are going to have, you know, their Fiverr profile optimized for those types of searches, or have YouTube videos around it and whatnot, or their books on Amazon. So just to give you an idea, I use something that, you know, I found on Leadbird. I know the Leadbird guy, Nick, and I figured I would use him as a subject for this video. So they had this on there, only paper lead. And you could grab this, we will launch your cold email campaigns, or, get paid for the meeting, ready, leads, little typo in there. There are a lot of sentences you can grab that, you know, make this a good fit. And then you obviously want to experiment with that a little bit, see the types of results that you're getting, and also to make sure that you're ignoring other specific things that would make it a bad fit. So in our case, here's G2. So I would want to add G2. So then you want to add like minus site g2.com. Let's do that here. So that would be minus site g2.com. And then there's no more G2 in here. So you want to optimize your search a little bit this way. And then you can see things come up, like companies come up that are going to be very tricky to find in Apollo and Sales Navigator. But this way you're able to identify them. Now, you don't get a lot of companies. Maybe there are like 30-ish companies in here. But these are companies that I would not have found otherwise. So that's great. And that is just one search term, right? So from their website, I will be able to identify 3, 4, 5 specific search terms. So imagine that would get me maybe between 50 and 100 unique companies, which in our case will be quite a lot because it's a fairly small market. And it can really help you build really targeted lists. You just look at, okay, what are my best clients and what is some common language that they have on their website? And you would use it that way. There's one example. So let's dive into Clay and see a couple of other examples. So here in Clay, what we did, we grabbed, so there's a couple of samples in here. We don't need the website, but it's just imagine you do a CRM export and you have your top 20 clients in here. Now for each client, you come up with some key phrases that you get from their website. And then you drop those in here. Maybe that secondary word in here, which is optional. So that is that second phrase or word that you have in there to narrow it down even further. And then you could perform a search. You can do it in Epiphy as well, and just have all these searches in Epiphy. That will give you a little bit of a cleaner, just an easier data set. Will get you all the data instead of having to map all the columns. And then you get all that data from Epiphy. I actually have it here to run. Let me see. So if you go into Epiphy, then here you get it. So you get a little bit of an easier data set to work with. You export it, and then you combine all those data sets that you have of all these different phrases. You have like 100 results in there. You upload that into Clay, and then you filter out some of the bad fits. You enrich them, and you apply some additional scoring. That will make your life a little bit easier, but I just want to run this through Clay just to show you how you could do it in Clay, just to show you what different churches look like, what a potential workflow could look like. So this is how you do it. You set it up. So you have all text here. Then you reference the key phrase here. You reference a secondary word in there. It's just the entire search that we did. But then, we reconstruct it in here. Number of results. I went 20 just for having this video, for doing this video. Everything else you can pretty much keep as is. And then you run that. And then that gets you these results right here. So they're the same results as what I have here. And then you can obviously decide to map the columns that you want to keep. So that's that. And just to show you how it works. So for line.ai, imagine you want to find companies really similar to line.ai, you would say, okay, write hyper-personalized emails. That is a sentence that we, for example, had on our website. Secondary will be AI, so use AI to write that. Then it comes with out-of-bound, which is a really good fit. Look at that, write hyper-personalized emails at scale with AI. That is out-of-bound, then GigaSheets. Then they have the option, so they have they're really similar to Clay, just a little bit more of a, let's say, a general use case, whereas Clay is really for lead generation, and obviously there are more differences, but you can use GigaSheet to do that, and obviously you can use Clay to do it, so Clay will be a very interesting find in this case, and then by peers, I would also be a really interesting find because they pretty much do the same thing. So that is how you can use that, and then obviously there's a lot of different ways you can go around that, you can go about that and clone your best clients. One other use case, just to get your creative juices flowing, one other thing you could use it for is imagine you work for a company like, I don't know, Chili Piper. Or Canonly or whatever. So you want to look for companies that have the phrase book a call on their website. So it could be like a CTA they have somewhere. And maybe as a secondary, you have SaaS. So book a call and see how we help SaaS companies, that type of thing. So this needs a lot more tweaking to really make it find the right companies. But once you do, it could be a really cool search to do as well. So let's go with the Chili Piper example. We want to find companies that target SaaS companies and they have the option to book a call on their website. And that could be a campaign that we could run saying, listen, you're targeting SaaS companies. We know you're not a Chili Piper client, but everyone who is starting SaaS companies, they need to have speed and efficiency. But because these SaaS companies are tech savvy, they really, they're in high, like they're really popular, people are going after them. So you want to make sure you optimize all the inbound leads that you get there. And with Chili Piper can help you with that. So you can build a list of companies offering a book a call option on their website. And then obviously, you can replace SaaS with whatever. You can replace book a call with book a demo, and have a different secondary word in there. It's probably not this specific use case. It probably wouldn't be the optimal way of going about it. You can probably just use different scrapers and go after different HTML elements, but it's a pretty cool use case, I think. And this, the book of calls is one example. You can do the same with the SOC compliance. You can do the same with different consulting offers, making sure that you're finding companies that are offering specific type of consulting. There are a million different ways that you can use that, if not a million, 100,000 at least. And it, as you can see, comes up with some pretty good, and I haven't optimized this at all whatsoever. So it comes up with some really good examples of companies selling to SaaS, companies that have the book a call option on our website. And then if you work for Trilly Piper, you can go after these companies and say, hey, we can help you do things better. So that is how you use the all in-text search operator to either build lookalike audiences to find ideal leads or find guest posting opportunities, or sky's the limit. Another, again, you have 100,000 opportunities at least to use this for your lead generation efforts. Hopefully you will find this helpful. Then if you did, let me know, a comment, a like, anything that will help me make more videos like this. And then in the next video, we'll dive into more options to make lookalike audiences. For now, thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Bye-bye.